The Klein's antique story. Go ahead.
Well, we went down to Klein's junk farm one Saturday, and it was a real cold winter day, so we stopped over in Concord at Shoney's and had breakfast. It was all you could eat.
Just sit down. It's like 5 minutes.
It's really not.
It was greasy. The bacon and stuff was just floating in grease, and everything was greasy, and we went down there and pigged out. We ate all we could hold, and then we went on down to the junk farm. And we stayed together for a while, and then somehow she went her way and I went my way. We didn't have cell phones back then. So after about 30 minutes, I started looking for her, wondering where she was. So anyway, one of those long chicken houses that's full of antiques and junk, I started in the doorway, and way down at the other end, there she stood. So I walked down there, and when I got about 10 feet away from her, I began to realize she didn't look quite right. And I walked up and I said, "What is the matter with you?" And she said, "If I move one muscle, I'm gonna poop all over myself." And I said, "Joy, you don't come down here to the junk farm in that condition. You know he doesn't have a bathroom. He had an outhouse, but the back wall fell out of it. And you don't come down here like that. You know better." And she said, "Oh, I felt fine when we left Concord." And I said, you had to know something.
He chewed me out big time.
And she, I said, "Well, I can't help you. I mean, there's nothing I can do." I said, "If you get to where you can walk," I said, "get to the truck and I'll take you to Mount Pleasant." So finally she got to where she could take these little baby steps, and she just grunting and going, and got her in the truck and drove hard as I could go back to Mount Pleasant. And there's a little cafe there with a gravel parking lot. I came sliding up to the door, and she jumped out and ran in there. About 5 minutes later, she came out, and she said, "Whew, I feel good now. I feel a whole lot better." And I said, "Are you ready to go home?" She said, "Well, no, we were going to get an old dresser or something other. So let's go back." I said, "Okay." So we went back down there, and she took off over there. I went this way. About 30 minutes later, she comes walking in this long chicken house at one end, and I'm down at the other end looking at a piece of furniture. And she walked up to me, and she said, "What's the matter with you?" And I said, "If I move one muscle, I'm going to poop all over myself." And she started laughing and cackling. And I said, "Don't laugh, it hurts." And she laughed that much more. Well, finally, and I knew I couldn't make it to the truck.
And I can't drive the truck.
I was in way worse shape than she was, apparently, because I knew there's no way I can make it to that truck.
Well, you couldn't drive in that shape, and I couldn't drive it.
There's one more building. It's a big, long building. And the back side of that furthest building is right at the woods. And I said, "You know what? If I can make it to the woods up there, I'll be fine." So I finally got to where I could take these little steps like that, and I was just grunting, you know, and everything. And I went up through that building, and I began to pick up speed. I was trotting, and then I was flying. And there was a table there, about like this table here. And it was real dusty, and somebody had took a sleeve off of a flannel shirt and had been dusting on it, looking to see, I guess, how good the finish was. And it left that sleeve laying there. And I grabbed it when I ran by, and when I ran out in the woods, I was popping the dust out of it like that. And I made it to the woods just in the nick of time. So that's the story of Klein's Antiques.